Well, meanwhile, the Health Parliamentary Committee has today visited the screening and testing facility at Peniel Beach in Entebbe, where people going out of the country and coming into the country are tested for COVID-19. Now, the visit was aimed at ensuring that the centre meets the standards to eliminate possibilities of travellers infecting others with COVID-19.
The delegation of members of parliament was led by the chairperson of the committee, Dr. Charles Sayume. During the tour, MPs tasked the coordinator to explain how the facility operates.
The objective of this visit was fact-finding. It's within our scope. To oversight is within our scope. And we came here. First question, is this facility necessary? It is very necessary, in the sense that we anticipate a third wave as a country, and monitoring of border entry points, ports of entry, is one of the pillars of WHO in management of epidemics. So Ministry of Health is exercising its mandate in terms of management of epidemics.
According to Dr. Ayume, it was important that they visit the center as the country plans for the third wave. However, the fee charged here remains a challenge for many travelers.
Of treating a patient in ICU is 3 million shillings per day. Let's have that at the back of our heads before we look at the financial and social inconvenience. 3 million shillings per day, that's an audit that was done by Ministry of Health. In the private sector, it's 3.5 million shillings. So, madam, if you had a patient in ICU for 20 days, times 3 million shillings, that would be about 60 million shillings. And yet somebody could have just paid $65 and walked through.
According to the coordinator, the facility has six laboratories which can produce 26,000 results per day.
There is testing at the land borders. I think someone here should, one of these laboratories. Now that we have enough capacity, there is actually testing at the land borders. I wanted to correct that. But it needs strengthening. You know that our land borders are so porous, and the movement across the border is like a livelihood. So we are working with our colleagues in immigration, our colleagues in security at the border points to ensure that this process is well managed. But the laboratories, the private labs posting, you heard the honorable members of parliament saying that there's testing in Elegu, there's testing at Malaba, there's testing at the Busia borders, and all the other border points. Some are managed by the districts and other border points are managed by...
Ugandans have, however, been warned that testing alone does not prevent them from contracting the virus. Story by Godfrey Sempija for the news in Entebbe.